Today, I'm gonna show you and I'm gonna explain how every single great rune in Elden Ring works. First, let me show you how they look. And I'm gonna explain how they also how you can get them. Basically, we have 7 different great runes. This one, the Godric's, Rykard, Radahn, Morgoth, Mog, Malenia, and the final one, which is a little bit of a special great rune, is the one from the Unborn, from the Renala. Now, as you can see, this with little circle I have equipped on me. And you can get these great runes by defeating the main bosses in Elden Ring. Only by that. By defeating the main bosses in Elden Ring, you're gonna get for every single one great rune. Everything is easy until now. Now, the next step, it will be to a Lost Grace, a side grace, no matter where you are. Just rest and you can equip different great runes. Obviously, we're gonna start with this one, with the Godric great rune. Let's equip it. And as you can see, it says rise all attributes, but that's not all. It's not enough for you to equip it. I'm gonna explain what else you have to do. Basically, on the map, you'll find a lot of arc runes. Bro, I always get lost in this building, always. After 300 of hours of gameplay, I always get lost here. Now, this is a location where you can buy those arc runes, and I'm gonna explain how they work. As you can see, we have them 5 right over here. You know what, let's buy them all because I'm gonna need them for this video. And with this one, let me show you what you have to do. We're gonna teleport in this location, let's say. It's a mid-game location, not something from the beginning. And here I'm gonna show you by example every single rune, what it can do. We're gonna take them with the first one, with the Godric great rune, the one that you see right now on the left side on the top corner. As you can see, that one is not active. Now I'm gonna explain you how that works. I'm level 187 and these are my stats. I know there are all over the place, but I don't care. I just do that because I want to make a lot of video with weapons. Don't worry. As you can see, my vigor is 47 and every single stat is right here. And let's see what will happen after you're gonna use an arc rune. So this is after you're gonna consume it, it will disappear. I have 14 of this, so lucky for me because I can use them all to show you for every single great rune what we can do. So for the Godric great rune, let's use it. And everything has been charged, as you can see. Now every single of my stats now are increased by 5%. Vigor, mind, endurance, strength, dexterity, intelligence, fate, arcane, everything gets maxed with 5%. But that will keep only and only until you die. If you're gonna die, or if you're gonna change that great rune, that effect will disappear. You can teleport, you can do whatever you like, but when you will die, that will disappear. So yeah, this was the first one. Now it's time for us to go to the next one. Let's see what we have next. Let's equip it to this gray site. We have next the great rune of Rykard. This will restore HP upon defeating enemies. Let's put it on me. Now it's on me, it's active. The Rykard great rune is right here. So now it's time for us to activate it, because it's not active. I know I'm gonna spend a lot of this, but I don't care. I just want to show you for the purpose of this video. Now I have a regular sword, doesn't matter what sword I have, and I'm gonna hit it once and I'm gonna let him hit me. Okay, as you can see, my health is lowered right now. Oh, it's lower by a lot. I didn't want to die. I don't want to die. Let me just hit me one. Okay, now as you can see, if I will defeat this enemy, look at my life. It just regen by itself, only because of that rune. So basically, that great rune does it to regen your life after you're gonna defeat one enemy. You have to kill that enemy in order to get for your life to be regen. To regain, gain back your life, basically. Let me. That's it. This is the Rykard rune, the serpent one. By the way, if you don't know how to get all those great runes, I have a video on my channel exactly how you can do that very easy with every single location. So better watch that video. I'm gonna put it in this video description of how you can get every single great rune. Now let's go to the next one. Raise maximum HP, FP and stamina. Basically, when you put this on you, the Radahn great rune, let me show you. Bro, what I just did? My stats are, look at my stats, my health bar, my top corner or top left corner, my stats, every single stat, my stamina, my everything, it's like you are seeing right now. Let me show you. Stamina, it's 127 HP. This is my HP, AFP, and now let's see what will happen when you activate this Radahn great rune. Basically, you have to go in the inventory, use it. Look at my health bar, everything is rise up. They will significantly increase. And let me show you, bro. Why I keep pressing? Okay, stamina, it's up by 9 points. I think it was 37, and everything has been increased. Pretty awesome, right? Or 10, but basically you got the point. From the Radahn you'll get stamina, FP and health. Let's go to the next one. Now for the next one, if you are talking strictly about HP and if you just want a crazy amount of HP, you can go right over here. You can take the Morgoth great rune. As you can see, greatly rises maximum HP, an awesome one. So let's go ahead and put it on. And now again we have to do the same step. I have to consume my rune arc in order to activate it. So look at my HP. Let's see, you know what, let's see what HP I have right now. 1611. And now it's time for me to consume that arc. Look at my HP bar, it has been increased by a lot, trust me, by a lot. Pro 2014, more than Godric and more than Radahn. Because yes, on the both of those you're gonna get increased HP. And if you want even more HP, you can have some really nice on your inventory. You can have this maximum rise HP, but I think there are more items that can risely by great your HP. I think there are a lot of here. This one, okay, slowly restored HP. I have a lot of I don't know, I'm just trying to see. No, I think this one is the okay. Here you got another one. And look at my health bar now, bro, this is crazy. Look at, and vigor, I don't have that a lot of vigor. Let's see, 47, not that much, but look how it has been increased only by doing that. Now let's go to the next great rune. The Mog's rune, it's a little bit more complicated because it will require you to invade someone, or you'll be able to receive some extra powers when we invade someone. Let me show you what I'm talking about. Basically what this rune is all about, it's only about online gameplay. If you don't want to play in online, if you don't want to lose invites, this will be useless for you. This is only for online play. Now, enemies inside the invaded world receive a blessing of blood, which boosts their attack power when blood loss occurs nearby. Now, I'm just gonna read you the description. I think it's better this way. Also, your HP recovers when blessed enemies defeat a player. So, this is what it does. I don't know, this will be the best thing for you, even though if you like to invade players. I did that a few times and I never used this great rune. Maybe probably it's not for me, it's not too complicated, but I prefer the one with the HP, or yeah. I will repeat really fast so maybe you can understand me even better. Enemies inside the invaded world receive a blessing of blood. So the enemy is not the host, which boosts their attack power when blood loss occurs nearby. I don't know the proximity, but it never says. Also, the HP recovers when blessed enemies defeat a player. That's it. This is what this rune does. And you know what? Let's just go to the next one because this one for me is too annoying. Again, I think I'll never use this one. We gonna go to the last one, to the attack to the Malenia's Great Rune. Attacks recover HP after damage is taken. Let me show you what that means. And we have to go to activated and let's see what we have this in inventory. Not here, bro. Here we go. Let's see if it will say. A great rune, the blessing of this Hofrath, reduce the healing power of the... Yeah, it will reduce the healing power of your flask and the crimson tears. So you will not receive that much of a healing power after when you will have this active on you. And yet, due to the infusion of Malenia Spirit of Resistance, attacks made immediately after receiving damage will partially recover HP. I probably know you already already defeat Malenia, and you know why. When a Malenia attack, she will receive a lot of HP back if you damage her. So basically these runes do exactly the same thing. Now you know what, let's activate it and let me do an example right over here. Here we are. Now it's active. And just look at, I'm gonna show you something. Look at my health bar. Just look at that. I'm gonna leave this one to hit me. As you can see, there is a red thing right over there. And when you attack, let me show. Okay, we have to do it. Quickly attack. Yeah. As you can see, when I attack, don't matter if I defeat that enemy or not. But my sword is too strong not to defeat that enemy. I will gain back some HP. So also the flask, they will not heal me as much as they were heal me before. And now let's see again. I'm gonna show you. I know how to explain this one. The life that you are seeing with the pink, not red, with that, I think it's a pink bar. If I quickly attack my target, it will regen a part of it. As you just saw right now. So, basically, this one is pretty awesome. But I don't like it very much because your crimson tear flask, they will not work properly. So again, if we are talking about that, I don't like it very much. Only about because my flask are not working like they should. For me, this is not the one that we have to. Okay. As you can see, my health is regen. If you attack very fast after you're gonna take damage, basically that's it. If you wanna take a little bit of a damage and you attack very very fast your target, you're gonna get your health back. And imagine what you can do with a stronger enemy. It's a pretty great rune, but probably not my choice. If I will have to choose only one, probably I'm gonna get the one with the max HP or the one. Let me show you really fast. If I have to choose only one, I think the one that I really like. Bro, I think maybe this one restore HP upon defeating enemies, depends what you are doing, or this one, the Radahn Great Rune, or even this one is pretty good. 5 to all attributes, pretty amazing. Now let me show you something else, the last one, because I promised that I'm gonna show you all 7 of them. For the last one, you have to be to the place where you just defeat Renala. Obviously, if you have that Great Rune, definitely you have defeat her already. You'll want to be right over here, and that great rune, it will only help you to rebirth. Basically, you're gonna need 2 different items. Let me show you. Don't have to activate, you cannot put it on you, equip it, and okay, born on you, it will help you to born on you, and you'll need this larva tier. With this item and with that great rune, you can talk with Renala right over here, and you have the options to rebirth. That it does. It does. You'll reset every point, every stats, and you'll accept a rebirth, and from now on you're gonna put your points wherever you like. That's it. Those are all 7 great runes and everything that you can do with them. Now you decide which one is better for you. I just want to explain in my way. I don't know if it's perfect the way that I explain, but I try to make it as good as possible. Thank you so much for watching. Hit that like button, subscribe, share, press the notification bell, and I'm gonna see you in the next one. Have a great day. Bye.